Cathedral City is a beautiful desert town framed by the towering San Jacinto Mountains. Cathedral City was the Coachella Valley's earliest center of art, spearheaded by Agnes Pelton. Positive Spin recently visited the restored Agnes Pelton House to interview Simeon Den and Peter Palladino, two co-founders of the Agnes Pelton Society, a nonprofit organization established to promote the life, art, and legacy of Agnes Pelton.
Can you tell us about Agnes Pelton and her significance to the art world?
Agnes Pelton is very interesting in the way that in the 1913 Armored Show, it was in New York, it was a kind of pivotal show in the art world where America was first introduced to Picasso, Duchamp, Kandinsky, you know, all these modern, who now are modern masters, in 1913. So it really changed the shape, I mean, the direction of art. At that point, she was one of the few Americans in that show, let alone one of the few women. So she established her career. She was a young woman. She was from Europe, from Germany, and she grew up in Boston, in Brooklyn. But she established herself from that show, and from that time, from there, she started to travel. Around 1919, when she did figurative paintings, she started experimenting with abstracts, transcendental, which she called the transcendental painters. And the best way I can explain that is she was a contemporary of Georgia O'Keeffe. I think they met once, but she said once that what Georgia did was paint the beauty, external beauty of a flower, and what she aspired to do was to paint the spirit of it. So she later on, in the 40s, organized a group of painters, all other ones were men, and they called themselves the Transcendental Painters, and all of their objective was to paint the spirit out of the painting. So that's why she was so wonderful at painting light. I mean, she really trained herself to characterize light in all her paintings. And in fact, the last showing that they did of her when she came back to prominence about 18 years ago was a show curated by the Palm Springs Museum. It was called The Poet of Light.
What impact did she have in the Coachella Valley?
That's so interesting because I think most people who, when she moved here and lived in the Cathedral City, there were only six houses in 1938 when she completed building this house. I think to a lot of people, to a lot of locals, she was just the old lady who lived down the street who painted. And so she quietly painted, and she organized a group of artists who would come, friends would come and paint with her, and teach painting and show work. There were also, her friends included dancers and composers and writers. And it was an instance of like, almost like Petticoat Junction, I think, of Green Acres, you know, like it was a rural community, pretty much isolated except for Palm Springs. And these established, accomplished artists would come and do their work and show.
I bought the house, it was totally a mess. I didn't know until we were in escrow who Agnes Pelton even was. Since then, I found out that this front door, this was all blocked in. I realized that the front door was in the guest house when they rearranged everything, when they built it. But so I did found that, I found the niche. I've been trying to get it back to the integrity. All the bones are still there. Agnes's friend, Christina Lillian, who started the Palm Springs Museum, and all these people have fallen out of history. Since then, I've given talks to like Americans of the Daughters of the American Revolution. Liz Armstrong from the museum introduced her to Christina Lillian and all the newspaper articles and all of the stuff that founded and backs up the fact that she was an integral part of the past. These are all people that were, missing in history that I just fell into by investigating Agnes. So I really know Agnes from 1932. Not prior. So
we established the Agnes Pelton Society about 8 years ago, and when we first moved here, we worked with the Historical Society, and they recognized the prominence. And so for a while, we actually did organize home tours of other historic homes in the area every year, and then we started to just focus on our own. The Agnes Pelton Society decided to just focus on this house itself, trying to designate it as a on the National Registry. And our mission is to support her legacy. You know, this woman, like there's a story about her, the poignant story about she lived and painted in this house, over 20 years. And because she was destitute towards the end, she couldn't die here. They moved to a little shack down the street, and she died there, 6 months later. And how poignant is that, right? So so we want, because of that, in part because of that, is that, that we want to support her legacy and bring her, keep her name alive and in the art world. So what we do in to do that, one of the things we do that is we commission local artists to paint murals in this alleyway back here. So we've commissioned so far about 7 artists, they're all local artists, to depict parts of the history of Cathedral City, of the Cathedral City Code. We do, for about 5 years now, we've been doing a monthly free art class. We call it the Children's Art Party. And we, it's designed so that older, like, generationals can get together. So we say the grandparents can come and make art with the children, who their mission is to work with recyclable materials. So we teach the children how to do that. We also invite another artist, a local artist, to come and speak and teach the children. So half of the hour is with one of the artists, and then half of the hours with what we do, certainly. That we offer this scholarship for a local high school student, Cathedral City High School student, who's interested in the arts. And pretty much those are the three major things that we do.